There's a great quote from Hamlet, "Buy indirections, find directions out." I love the idea that you can, in fact, set off in totally the wrong direction and just trust that the world will be there to steward you to the place that you are seeking. The way we're exploring the solar system today relies on something called slingshotting. A spacecraft uses the gravitational pull of a planet or maybe a moon to slingshot itself toward another, more distant goal. You can send a craft that might only be able to get a little bit past the moon, for example, all the way to the very edge of the solar system, because it's taking advantage of almost a conveyor belt of gravitational pulls, indirectly traveling to a final destination. What's really interesting, though, is that this is not a new technique. Even 1,000 and more years ago in the South Pacific, mariners were using the same basic concept to get from one island chain to the next. They too were slingshotting themselves. They were using currents, winds. They were using generational storms to get themselves from one world to the next. You can imagine these mariners as the NASA scientists of their day, even creating these stick charts of the world. They were cartographic devices comparable to the kinds of interplanetary diagrams you might find in a classroom or a laboratory at NASA. Imagine these ancient families standing on the shore, looking out at the horizon. Then one day the skies click back into place. The winds are picking up. Ominous Antarctic clouds are appearing on the southern horizon again. And everybody knows what these signs really mean. They begin to build new canoes, their own wooden space probes for pushing the limits of a maritime universe. And then they depart, seeking out new worlds, indirectly.